lectures on this very interesting topic. Very good morning to all the dignitaries and ladies and gentlemen. This name is very new. I'll be just breaking my presentation in just giving a brief overview of the organization, and I'll be speaking on the practical aspects of all the what gentlemen have said in the last 15 minutes. How as an organization we actually harness the technology, what we do, what kind of technologies we use, and how we actually stop the illicit trade from our organization and across the, I would say, the cross-border terrorism, what we all are facing the minutes about. This is a very, I would say, old company. We just got listed on the New York Stock Exchange around a month back in the May, and we got separated from Johnson & Johnson as a consumer health division. So, my name is Vinil Palani. I head the Southern Asia and the ANZ cluster. I'm the part of Kenview Legal and Compliance team. I'll be speaking on this practical aspects of what actually we are doing in the organization to stop them, combat the actual illicit trade, what our organization is facing. I'll just say about the purpose of the organization is about realizing the extraordinary power of everyday care. I'm just giving a brief overview. This is the world's largest pure play consumer health company by revenue. We have a net sales of close to $15 billion. We have a rich legacy history of more than 135 years, and we are present in more than 165 countries. As we recently got listed, we have a geographical presence across the globe, where we have a share of 50% in North America, 21% in Middle East, Africa and Europe, 21% in APAC, and 8% in LATAM. So we are really, I would say, geographically distributed, across the globe. These are, I would say, three different segments or, verticals where our products are present, in self-care, skin health and beauty and essential health, and we connect with almost 1.2 people globally on their daily rituals and the movement that matter the most. These are few of our well-renowned trademarks in the self-care division. I'm sure each and everyone would have used one of our products in our day-to-day life. And some more about Johnson's, Neutrogena, Aveeno, OGS. And everyone would have used Band-Aid, Listerine, which we use in our day-to-day life. These are some of our products. Let me quickly move on to the, I would say, specific focus, what we actually do. There is a need to collaborate with businesses and the other stakeholders to create a more secure and transparent global system, I would say. So if you look at this slide, there is an enterprise brand protection council within our organization where we work very closely with the legal and compliance team, commercial, regulatory affairs, and the finance supply chain to make sure that if there is any illicit trade, any kind of, issues we are facing with regards to counterfeiting, diversion of capital, we work very closely as one group. And at every stage within our organization, right from research and development, raw material manufacturing, and our end-to-end business value and supply chain, we do make sure that we work very closely and collaborate with them. If you see on the left-hand side, there are a lot of names where we work globally with a lot of vendors like React. There are some lot of technology suppliers on that left-hand side of the box. And somewhere down the line, some of our products, depending on the need of the hour, we do embed a lot of technologies Over within our product, so that at every stage, is there anything wrong which is happening inside the market, we do have a look at it and we get a quick understanding of what we need to do. On the industry partners, we collaborate with most of the consumer product, I would say, organizations, and we work very closely. We share the best practices and see findings. We also collaborate very closely with the industry, I would say, association, not only in India, across the globe, and we are a global team. So we have, I would say, representation in most of the, I would say, important forums where we do raise our voice and we do voice out on this important issue of the illicit trade and the balance we all are facing. We work very closely with Thinking Cascade, CPAP, IACC, QBPC, INTA, and especially with the APAC. We even, I would say, work very closely with the university as well to inculcate and to teach the students what the problem is at the very beginning of the stage. So, we do hire interns, we do hire co-ops, and we teach them about the problems right from the conceptual and the inceptual stage. And of course, we work very closely with many government agencies as well across the globe in solving the cross-border, I would say, investigation cases. Let me move on to the point with regards to the use of technology to detect and prevent illicit trade activities. If you see in the center box, that's the end-to-end value supply chain. As an organization, we see there's an authorized supply chain where the product moves from supplier to the manufacturing, warehousing, authorized distributors, and wholesalers. What we see in the illicit supply chain is people try to infringe the original supply chain and they try to mix the product. And at the end, we see, as a result of that, there are counterfeits, diversion and tampered products. And the end consumer not gets the right product instead of the original product what he is supposed to get. This causes a loss of reputation, brand. There is a problem if there is an injectable product, he intakes it, there is a patient safety threat and health issue as well. safeguard the marketing, we do a lot of things. There is a, I would say, product returns where a lot of, I would say, returns come in the market. We do a proper thorough auditing scanning. We do market surveys. We work closely with the customs to ensure what Mr. Todd said. We have a custom recordation global program. We work with entities like React, where we have a global, I would say, country by country trademark recordation with the custom agencies. There's a proper, I would say, online internet monitoring, gathering of the online intelligence. As per online enforcement, and of course, on, I would say, from online to offline investigation in the actual enforcement, where we work with various multiple nodal agencies in India and across various countries. This illicit trade analytics is a very broad topic, I would say. There's a lot of, I would say, ton of data, what my colleague from KPMG said. Within our organization, we have tons of data where we need to do a lot of analysis. We work with Tableau systems. We do look into the customer care complaints. We analyze it. I would say there's a lot of, I would say, analysis or a lot of internal data where we work closely with our sales team to identify the hotspots, where there's a dip of sales, where the hotspots are, what are the trends which are emerging, why there's a loss of sales. And we do a lot of accordingly proactive and reactive actions depending on what kind of consumer complaints we get. On the top end of the left hand side of the box, there's a lot of enhancing of supply chain integrity where we work on. Where there are a lot of things where we as an organization within the brand protection, we do to enhance our own supply chain by putting a lot of elements into the packaging, I would say designing features, digital authentication or AI, security seals, and there's a lot of best practices we follow within our organization. Safe and secure our own supply chains. This is a very interesting topic which India is recently, I would say, not immune and privy to it. That's the online brand protection space where we refer into e-commerce, which is B2B, B2C, or I would say any app or any platform where our products get sold. So, as we what we are seeing, our organization where we are seeing 100% increase in the sales from the traditional brick and mortar channels. Lot of, I would say, sales are moving, and as and when we are seeing the advent in use of mobile data, it is spreading very fast in tier 2, tier 3, tier 4 cities where everyone has a mobile, everyone has access to 4G, 5G technologies. Everyone wants to shop on Flipkart or any B2C or any B2C or B2B platform. Typically, what as an organization we do is we do continuous expansion of the enterprise online marketing program to combat the illicit trade, mitigating the consumer risk and for recovering the financial loss of the illicit channels. So there's a lot of, I would say, information in one slide, but this is the four-step process what we follow within our organization. There's a continuous online monitoring and enforcement we do where we work with majority of the B2C players within India or I would say across any of the organizations. My boss sits in China, she is on the Alibaba anti-counterfeiting clients board, so we have a permanent seat within the, I would say, the biggest, I would say, player in Alibaba, where we meet quarterly at their Hangzhou or the Hengjian office, and we do share our wins as well locally. Typically, if you see from a capabilities perspective, there is a test purchase which is required to be done. What Mr. Dugal said, there is a proper legal law. If I go to any B2C platform, they will not delist any seller. They have to properly follow the law, you have to adhere to the guidelines, you have to register your trademarks with the Amazon brand registry or various, I would say, the trust programs they have. So, you do online monitoring, you do, I would say, a specific monitoring of the products. Then there is a partnership which is required to be done with various players, and you will follow the compliance, and then there is a job progression. From a purchase, you need to understand what kind of purchase you need to do in a covert way within the online platforms. And, I would say there's a lot of link analysis and lot of information.
We are only telling on the public forum now. When they're retiring now,
there's an auditable trade available. At the end of the day, he's receiving money in his bank account.
He was good.
But it is not that. Trade is not that. The person is actually receiving money from Amazon or from any player because he's doing the business. So there's an individual who is actually receiving the money and it is auditable and trade. I come from Mumbai. We in Maharashtra have an agency called Bilpur that is specifically for Maharashtra Intellectual Property Private. We work closely with them on a few cases. Their requirement is the invoice has to be from the Maharashtra jurisdiction. They do a lot of audit trailing and backending, and they do, I would say, take this cyber crimes case very seriously. Online intelligence, get, I would say, there's an IQ analysis, link analysis, open source intelligence methodology which is available. There are crawlers various which are available. You work with this online, I would say, intelligence tool, you will do the joining of the dots and we find the big fish is available offline, we sell the product. Yeah. And finally, there is an online to offline intelligence as well, where we do a product security investigations and end-to-end actions and also the end-to-end illicit supply.
Yeah, coming.
That is it from my end. I would say, the government is valuable and insightful.
They were into extra seats.